Cougar foul, number 10, Sydney Freeman, her third, team six.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
As the calendar has turned to the month of May, it is officially ping pong ball season here in the IHSAA offices. A week ago, it was the softball selection process. This week, we focus on the baseball pairing show. Thank you so much for joining us on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. I'm your host, Greg Rakestraw. We're going to show you the field of 384 teams that comprise the 2019 Baseball State Championship Series, which, as always, culminates at Victory Field in downtown Indianapolis. What is different? The dates of the finals this year. We'll get to that in a moment. You can tell the gentleman to my right is Bobby Cox, the commissioner of the IHSAA. Lots for us to talk about in this opening segment. Good to see you as always, my friend.
Good to see you, Greg. Thank you.
All right, let's get right to the headline. Again, baseball finishes at Victory Field, but for just the second time since Victory Field has opened, it's not going to be the traditional Father's Day weekend. Tell us about it.
That's correct. Every once in a while, the Indians, when they schedule their games, we'll run into a conflict, and this year was one of those where the weekend that we normally play is being occupied by the Indians. So we've moved our championships to the Monday and Tuesday after that weekend. We're going to play two doubleheaders, and I think it's going to work out pretty well. We're going to play them later in the afternoon, kind of a twilight doubleheader on both days, and I think that'll help fans get there, and I think it'll be a nice environment for us.
So Monday, June 17th, Tuesday, June 18th, 4 and 7:30 are the scheduled start times. And as far as which teams are playing what date and what time, that determination will be made after the semi-state, correct?
That is correct. We'll look at the winning schools from each of the semi-states and then make a determination based upon the distance they have to travel and hopefully maximize the opportunity for our fans to get there.
And, of course, you can see those games right here on the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, which for both baseball and softball includes Fox Sports Indiana as well. One more thing about the Indianapolis Indians. I know they tried their darndest to have us there on Father's Day weekend, which says a lot because that's a profitable weekend for baseball teams. And much like we say about every championship, You have a wonderful partner in the Indianapolis Indians and Randy Lewandowski.
We do. Randy's a great supporter of the IHSA, and I know the organization worked very hard to try to get us in on that weekend, but it just didn't work out. And, you know, they got to work their business too, and we understand that. We want to be good partners with the Indians as well as all of our supporting partners. So it'll work out fine for us. We'll play baseball, and we'll determine four champions.
And one of the great things that they have done, and we see this at other locations as well, there is a championship jersey on display from your four champions down the left field concourse at Victory Field year-round.
And one of the treats I get personally is that when the game is over, the players come up with the rest of their fans, and we do a little presentation when they hang their jersey and their hat in that glass locker, and it is on display for the entire year. So it's a little thrill for me and a great display of our championships there. It's there all year long in Victory Field. We're very pleased about that.
All right, we're going to get to the pairings in just a matter of moments. But again, there's a couple of things that I felt we needed to get to off the top of the show. And one of those is a passing of a great friend to all of us in the state of Indiana and someone that you were able to recognize in the last few years. Of course, longtime Indiana Senator, former Indianapolis Mayor Dick Lugar passed away earlier this week, and there was a special award that you helped create for him and honored him with a few years ago. Tell us about it.
Yes, well the association is send our condolences to Char Lugar and the entire Lugar family for the passing of Senator Lugar. I had the great privilege of having an award named after Richard Lugar. We were privileged to present him with the first award, and then now we've presented it two other times, and he was able to be with us the second presentation so that he could make that to former IHSA Commissioner and NFHS Executive Director Bob Gardner. We are humbled that we're able to present that award, and we're going to miss Senator Lugar.
No doubt about that. Now, earlier this week on Monday, it was executive committee meeting. It was the realignment of sectionals for both the fall and the winter, but it was also a couple of rules changes, not affecting baseball, but some things that simply wanted to make sure we kind of discuss since you and I have this forum on a regular basis this time of the year. Tell us about the changes coming from Monday afternoon.
Well, I think the most pertinent change that sports fans will notice is that it's two changes, and it deals with football. And the first one was that we increased the number of quarters that a football player can play in a football week in a combination of varsity and junior varsity from 5 quarters to 6 quarters. We did that in concert with a passage of a mercy rule by the executive committee in the meeting immediately after the board of directors. So what this allows for is for our varsity football coaches in games that are blowouts, when the score gets to 35 points or greater at the beginning of the second half, we're going to go to a running clock. Well, when you allow for football coaches to have youngsters play 6 quarters, now that football coach that's ahead by 35 or more can put the JV team in.
Right.
And we can get the game over with. And I think it has a lot of value. I think, number one, it's going to help sportsmanship. There's nothing good happening when it's 70-0 in
right.
a football game. Secondly, I've walked out of a football field with fans going out the same gate in a 70-0 game. It's not good. Secondly, if it's 70-0, there's probably a physical mismatch out there on the field.
Right.
And I have a little concern about the health and safety of young people when we have a mismatch of that nature. So I think the changing of allowing quarters to be played plus the mercy rule is a real good change for football.
And, of course, like we said, the sectional realignments were announced in the fall and winter sports. And much like more information about these rule changes, you can find them all at IHSAA.org. But you are here for the baseball pairings, and let's get to those in a matter of moments. Bobby, as always, thanks for the time, my friend. I'll see you at Victory Field coming up in mid-June.
Thank you.
Again, that's the commissioner of the IHSAA and Bobby Cox. Now time for the pairings. We start in 1A. We start, as we always do, northwest corner of the state, sectional 49 in 1A. The defending champ, Morgan Township, and they will play the first game in this 8-team sectional as they take on Couts. Other matchup in the top half of this bracket, 21st Century Academy of Gary will take on Westfield. To the lower half of the bracket, Washington Township, rated 8th in the coaches' poll this week, they'll take on Marquette Catholic in game number 1. Last two teams on the board here on the opening sectional of our broadcast, Covenant Christian of DeMott will take on Hammond Academy of Science and Technology. Sectional number 50. This is held at Caston. It is a seven-team sectional. Northfield is the defending sectional champ. In fact, made all the way to the semi-state in Kokomo a season ago. They'll take on North White in game number one, with the winner getting Southwood in the semifinals. In the bottom half of the bracket, it is South Newton and Caston, West Central, and North Miami. Sectional number 51, this is hosted by South Bend Career Academy. The Satellites of South Central of Union Mills have won this sectional each of the last 3 years. They'll take on Argus in game number one, with the winner getting the host school, South Bend Career Academy, in a semifinal. Bottom half of the bracket, La Crosse and Triton, Calder Community, and Oregon Davis. Sectional number 52, this is held at Fremont. And again, Fremont is the defending sectional champ. They made the regional final last year. They'll take on Fort Wayne Blackhawk Christian in game number one. Blackhawk Christian receiving votes in this week's coaches poll. They are a former three-time state champion. Other matchup in the top half of the bracket in this six-team group, Elkhart Christian and Hamilton, then on to the semifinals for Bethany Christian and Lakewood Park Christian. Sectional number 53, Park Heritage is the host school. Five teams in this group, and Park Heritage as the host school gets number 9 Covington in game number one. Winner gets Attica in the semifinals. Top half of the bracket, Riverton Park is number 6 in the state, and they'll take on North Vermilion in their opening contest. Sectional number 54, this is hosted by Sheridan. Seven teams in this group. Rossville is the number one team in the state. They were the runners-up in 1A two seasons ago. They'll take on Tri-County in game number one, and the winner gets Clinton Central in the semifinals. Bottom half of the bracket, Sheridan and Faith Christian, Frontier and Pioneer. Sectional number 55. This is hosted at Daleville. Daleville, the defending sectional or defending state champions. Daleville, in fact, has won 4 sectionals in a row, two-time state champs in 2016 and 2018. First game out, West Allen Liberty Christian, with the winner getting Anderson Preparatory Academy. Then in the bottom half of the bracket, aforementioned Daleville against Triton Central. Daleville rated number 2 in the state this week. Southern Wells and Cowan round out the bracket in sectional 55. Sectional number 56, this is hosted by Seton Catholic. Union City won this sectional a season ago. They await the winner of Blue River Valley and Seton Catholic in game number one. Top half of the bracket, Tri and Randolph Southern. Sectional number 57, this is the first sectional in the lower half of the 1A draw. Shackamack and Eminence. Shackamack runners-up 4 years ago, state champs 5 years ago, and they have won 24 baseball sectionals over the year. Over the years. They take on Eminence in game number one, Clay City and White River Valley in game number two, to the bottom half of the bracket for North Central of Farmersburg and Bloomfield. Sectional number 58, this is hosted by Bethesda Christian University. The runners-up in 1A a season ago, led by head coach Chris Estep. They'll take on Providence Cristo Rey in game number one. Tinley and Bethesda Christian in game number two. And then in the semifinals, Indiana School for the Deaf and Traders Point Christian. Sectional number 59, this is at Morristown. Lutheran has won this sectional 7 consecutive years. They'll take on Morristown in game number one. Greenwood Christian in Edinburgh then in game number two. To the bottom of the bracket we go. Southwestern number 7 in the state this week. They'll take on Waldron in their opening game. Sectional number 60. This is hosted by Jack Sendell. Jack Sendell will take on Oldenburg Academy in game number one. The Eagles receiving votes in the coaches' poll this week. Then the defending sectional champs in Hauser, who made the regional final last year, they'll take on North Decatur in game number two. Rising Sun and South Decatur are on to the semifinals. Sectional number 61, 4 teams in this group. West Washington is the host. Orleans and Crothersville in game number one. Orleans won this sectional last year. Trinity Lutheran and West Washington in the other semifinal. Sectional number 62. This is hosted by Shaw Memorial. Born the defending sectional champs, they play New Washington in game number one, with the winner getting Shaw in the semifinals. Top of the bracket sees South Central and Christian Academy. Sectional number 63, this is at North Davies. Bar Reeve, number three in the state. They're in a semifinal. They'll take on Revay in game number one. First game will be Shoals, who's receiving votes in the coaches' poll this week. They'll take on Lagodi, with the winner getting North Davies. And finally, in sectional number 64, this is hosted by Tecumseh, a five-team group here, with Memorial and Candleton in game number one, with the winner getting Springs Valley. They're to the top of the bracket, Northeast Dubois and Tecumseh. Tecumseh rated number 10 in the state this week. There you go. Those are the pairings in Class 1A for 16 sectionals. We'll get to 2A when we come back as you're watching the 2019 IHSAA Baseball Pairing Show right here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Welcome back on the IHSA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. I'm your host, Greg Rakestraw. By the way, I want to clarify something because I gave you wrong times for the state finals. Again, they're taking place on Monday and Tuesday this year instead of the normal Friday and Saturday allotment. Two games each night, crossing our fingers, weather permitting, scheduled to start at 5:30 and 8:30. Those are the start times for the state championship games this year. 5:30 and 8:30 again, Monday and Tuesday after Father's Day on June 17th and June 18th. You can watch those right here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, as well as on the television home of the Champions Network, that being Fox Sports Indiana. 16 sectionals down, 48 more to go. Let's knock out those in 2A right here. We start in sectional number 33. This is hosted by Whiting, and Whiting gets the three-time defending sectional champs in Hammond Bishop Knoll. Knoll has won 27 baseball sectionals over the years. Other game in the top half of the bracket is Lake Station Edison and Gary Roosevelt. On to the semifinals for River Forest and Bowman Academy. Sectional number 34. This is hosted by Rensselaer Central. The Bombers get Hebron in game number one, followed by North Newton and Winnemac in game number two. In the semifinals, North Judson St. Pierre and the defending 2A state champions in Boone Grove. Sectional number 35. This is hosted by Westview. Prairie Heights and LaVille in game number one. LaVille receiving votes in this week's 2A coaches poll. Westview and Bremen in game number two. The defending sectional champs in Eastside get Central Noble in a semifinal matchup. Sectional number 36. This is hosted by South Adams. South Adams made the regional final last year. Churubusco and Woodland in game number one. Canterbury and Bluffton in game number two. Adams Central and South Adams, both ranked in the coaches' poll this week. They will face off in a sectional semifinal. Sectional number 37. This is hosted by Wabash, and the host school gets Rochester in game number one. Oak Hill and Lewis Cass in game number two. Cass receiving votes this week, and they are the defending sectional champs, as well as Whitco and Manchester. Manchester also receiving votes in the polls this week. Sectional number 38. This is hosted by Delphi. It is a 6-team group, and Delphi also receiving votes this week, taking on Seeger in game number 1, Clinton Prairie and Carroll of Flora in game number 2. Then it is Lafayette Central Catholic, 7-time state champs in 1A. They have won 10 straight sectional championships. That's the longest active streak in the state. They'll take on Weibo in their first game. The Knights, number 2 in the state this week. Sectional number 39. This is contested at Eastern of Greentown. 7-team sectional here, and Alexandria is the defending sectional champs. They're number 3 in the state this week, and they draw the bye. They get the winner of Tipton and Eastbrook in a semifinal. Bottom half of the bracket, Taylor and Elwood, Madison Grant, and the host school, Eastern of Greentown. Loaded group here in this 6-team sectional at LaPel. Frankton, who won this sectional last year, they made the regional finals. They'll take on Shenandoah in game number 1. Then it is Muncie Burris and number 6 Wapahani, runners-up in 2A 2 years ago in another opening round matchup. Then it is Monroe Central, who is number 5, taking on LaPel, who are receiving votes this week in the poll. Again, really talented sectional here at LaPel. Sectional number 41, this is at Centerville. 6 teams in this group. Union County is the defending sectional champs. They'll take on Northeastern in 1 quarterfinal. Before that, it'll be Winchester and number 1 Hagerstown. Then on to the semifinals, Cambridge City Lincoln and Centerville. Sectional number 42, this is at Triton Central. The host squad will take on Heritage Christian in game number 1. Then it is Cecina, led by Ball State-bound pitcher Mac Ayers. They made the semi-state last year. They'll take on Eastern Hancock in their opening game. On to the semifinals for Irvington Prep and Knightstown. Sectional number 43, this is hosted by Park Tudor, a 5-team sectional here. Park Tudor is receiving votes. They landed a victory over number 6 Wapahani last Saturday. They'll take on Cascade in game number 1. Winner gets the defending sectional champs in Covenant Christian. Top half of the bracket, Shortridge and Speedway. Sectional number 44, this is hosted by North Putnam. Cloverdale and Fountain Central in game number 1. South Vermilion, regional finalist from a year ago, takes on South Putnam in game number 2. On to the semifinals for North Putt and Monrovia. Sectional number 45, South Ripley is the host school here. Switzerland County, the defending sectional champs. They'll take on Austin, who's receiving votes in the polls this week in their opening game, with the winner getting South Ripley to the top of the bracket for Southwestern of Hanover and Milan. Sectional number 46, this is played at Lanesville. 6-team grouping here. Clarksville won this sectional a year ago. Lanesville, the 1A champs, playing up a level for the last couple of seasons, will host Crawford County in game number 1, Paoli and Eastern in game number 2. On to the semifinals, Clarksville and Henryville. Again, the Generals won this sectional last year. Sectional number 47. This is hosted by Mitchell. And Mitchell gets Southridge, made it all the way to Victory Field a season ago. Living one of the top baseball and basketball prospects in the state in Colson Montgomery. That is game number 1. North Knox and Eastern Green in game number 2. Then Linton Stockton. They, too, have a great baseball prospect in Kip Fugers. They're going to play at Indiana University. They've got a couple of young men heading to IU on this Linton Stockton team. They're number 10 in the state. They'll take on South Knox in a semifinal. And finally, at South Spencer. South Spencer, a 4-time former state champ. North Posey and Tell City in game number 1. Forest Park and Modern Day in game number 2. South Spencer onto the semifinals, where they will play host to Perry Central. So there you go. We are now halfway through the brackets here on the IHSAA Champions Network. When we come back, we'll talk to the assistant commissioner in charge of baseball. Robert Falkins joins us next as you're watching on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Hi, I'm Matt Wolford, president of the IHSAA Foundation, and we need your help. We need your help so the youth of our community can develop advanced leadership skills. We need your help giving high school administrators and coaches the instruction and insight they need to be better role models and teachers. To learn more or to make a tax-deductible contribution, go to IHSAAFoundation.org. You'll not only be contributing to the foundation of the IHSAA, you'll be contributing to the foundation of our community.
Again, welcome back on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Back to the brackets in just a matter of moments, but as we do on each of these pairings programs, you hear from the commissioner from the IHSAA and Bobby Cox, and you also hear from the assistant commissioner that is in charge of that sport. The gentleman joining us now, my good friend Robert Falcons from the IHSAA. Good to see you as always, and my guess is it's always good to be smack dab in the middle of baseball season.
Absolutely. That's a great way to end the season or end our athletic year with some outside activities. It's always fun.
Well, obviously, when you're dealing with outside activities, dealing with Mother Nature, has she been kind to baseball this
spring? She's won a lot this year.
Yes, she has.
She has just dominated the competition. But we're going to get it in. We have some innovative athletic directors and coaches, and they're going to do some things to make sure kids get opportunities to play.
As the assistant commissioner in charge of a sport, what does kind of the run of that season in baseball, about 2 months of regular season, about a month of postseason, what does that season look like for you?
It is very compact. There's a lot of stuff that has to happen. And then again, as you mentioned, Mother Nature is she runs the show. So we have to do a lot with a little bit of time, and we have to be very innovative in how we approach things. And a lot of our schools are very, very good at scheduling and making sure that we get those games in. Doubleheaders on the weekends, Friday, Saturday, three games for schools. It's a lot of fun, and I think what our coaches and our athletic directors are doing is good for the game of baseball.
One of the things that is unique, or many things that are unique about this sport and how it's played at the IHSA level, but you and I talked about this a year ago. You and I both grew up with a tradition of playing sectional games on Memorial Day.
Absolutely.
Some sectionals do that, some sectionals don't. One of the big reasons they do is you're kind of scheduling around graduation around that time. Your thoughts about how the first couple of weeks of the baseball tournament shakes out.
And just as you said, it's not just the graduations, it's all the other end-of-year celebrations that schools have. And, you know, we're subservient to the academic process, and so we have to be mindful of that. But it does present some challenges, but they're challenges that are kind of fun to do. And as we hear our coaches, we're after the draw today, and they see who they're going to play and how they're going to do it, it'll be fun to hear how to work out the tournament and get all of our games in. But you know, just like you said, that Memorial Day sectional championship was always a big deal.
No doubt about that. All right, from a scheduling standpoint, you got thrown another curveball this year as well from the Indianapolis Indians and really namely from the International League.
Yes.
One of the rare times they could not clear Victory Field for us. So Monday and Tuesday championship games, again, 5:30 and 8:30, the scheduled start time for those. Talk about what went into that decision, Robert.
Well, it really wasn't much of a decision. We want to be able to play our state championship at Victory Field, and those were the dates were available, and we're going to take those dates, and we're going to make the most of it. I think it presents us an opportunity again to have a unique state championship. We have a doubleheader on Monday and a doubleheader on Tuesday, and it gives parents a chance to get there. We hope that everyone's out of school by then, and then they can all come down and watch their classmates and their friends play, but it's an opportunity as much as it is a challenge.
Last thing that we'll do here in this conversation, talk about the role the Coaches Association plays in helping you administer this sport.
They're a huge help. You know, they're the boots on the ground, so to speak, and they know what's best for kids and they know what's best for the sport. We lean on them quite heavily. You know, a lot of times we have to say no because they want to do some things that we just can't do. But the beauty of it is that really care about the kids, they really think about the kids, and they think about the game and what's best for the game. And so sometimes we have to temper their enthusiasm, but most times they're a great help to me.
Robert, as always, thanks for the time, my friend. I'll see you at Victory Field in a few weeks.
Thank you for having me. I look forward to seeing you.
Robert Falcons, again, the assistant commissioner for baseball here with the IHSAA. We'll take this quick timeout. We'll come back with the 3A pairings as you're watching the 2019 IHSAA Baseball Pairing Special right here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
Sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
I don't think of this as a high school weight room. It's more like a high school classroom. I'm learning how to manage my time here. I'm learning that it's important to have goals and that it takes persistence and commitment to reach them. And I'm learning that the best way to lead is by example.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Welcome back on the IHSAA Champions Network. We appreciate you being with us. Of course, we're brought to you by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. I'm your host, Greg Rakestraw. Thanks to those behind the scenes, Heath Shanahan, Rick Vanderweiland, making sure our signal gets to you on this Sunday evening. We love the social interaction that you've been having throughout the course of tonight's program. Of course, IHSAA 1, IHSAA TV is how you can follow along on Twitter. Time to get back to the brackets now. Let's show you the pairings in Class 3A. We start in sectional number 17. Griffith is the host school, and they have won this sectional 7 consecutive years for head coach Brian Jennings. We start with Gary Westside in game number 1, taking on Hammond Gavitt. Calumet and Hammond Clark in game number 2. Griffith rated number 8 in the state this week. On to the semifinals, where they will play host to Hammond. Sectional number 18, Kankakee Valley is the host. Andrean is the team that gets the top level of attention. Twin Lakes and Knox in game number 1. Andrean, 6-time state champs. They'll take on Hanover Central in game number 2. 59ers, number 1 in the state this week. In the semifinals, Kankakee Valley and Wheeler. Loaded field here at Mishawaka Marion in sectional number 19. 7 teams in this sectional. Culver Academies takes on Mishawaka Marion, who is receiving votes this week. Winner gets number 10 South Bend St. Joe, who won this sectional last year, and they were the state champs in 3A just a couple of years ago. Bottom half of the bracket, Jimtown and South Bend Washington, Glenn and New Prairie. New Prairie is number 7 in the state this week. Sectional number 20. Northwestern is the host school here for this 6-team group. Maconaqua and Peru. Peru won this sectional last year. West Lafayette and Western in game number 2. Western, number 2 in the state, and a former state champion in 3A. Then we get to Northwestern and Benton Central. Benton Central, number 4 in the state this week. So again, this is a really packed group at Northwestern High School. Sectional number 21. This is at Wawasee. 7-team sectional here. Angola and Lakeland in game number 1. Winner getting Wawasee in the semifinals. Fairfield and Tippecanoe Valley in game number 2. Then it is Northwood and West Noble in game number 3. Northwood has won a baseball sectional in 6 straight seasons. Now we go to New Haven for sectional number 22. Again, 7 teams in this group. Bishop Dwenger and Columbia City in game number 1. Leo awaits in the semifinal. Both Dwenger and Leo receiving votes in this week's coaches poll. To the bottom half of the bracket, New Haven and Lures in game number 2. Then Garrett and Concordia in game number 3. Concordia won this sectional last year. Sectional number 23, this is hosted by Belmont. Marion and Norwell in game number 1. Norwell, of course, a great baseball tradition over the last 15 seasons. Belmont and Mississinewa in game number 2. Heritage and Jay County into the semifinals. Jay County made it all the way to the semi-state in Kokomo a season ago. Final sectional now in the northern half of the bracket. This is hosted by Blackford. 6 teams in this group. Blackford and Yorktown in game number 1. Yorktown won this sectional last year. Newcastle and Hamilton Heights in game number 2. Delta and Garin Catholic await in the semifinals. Garin Catholic now coached by former state championship winning coach Rich Andriol, number 6 in the state this week. to the southern half of the bracket in 3A we go. We start at North Montgomery. Five teams in this sectional. Southmont and Frankfort in game number one. Winner gets North Montgomery, who won this sectional last year. The Crawfordsville Athenians. Again, tremendous baseball history. Number three in the state this week. They'll take on Lebanon in one semifinal. Sectional number 26, Brebeuf is the host school here. Greencastle and Tri-West in game number one. The Bruins won this sectional last year. Winner gets Brebeuf in a semifinal. Top half of the bracket, Danville, who is receiving votes, takes on Cardinal Ritter. Ritter, the 2A champs from 2 years ago. Sectional number 27, this one on the turf at Bishop Chatard. Heron and Indian Creek. Indian Creek has won three straight sectionals. They made the semi-state last year. Winner of that game gets Chatard. Top half of the bracket, Manuel and Beech Grove. Sectional number 28. This is at Owen Valley. Five teams in this sectional grouping. Sullivan and Brown County in game number one, with the winner getting Owen Valley. Then you go to the top of the bracket, and two ranked teams will play each other. West Vigo and Edgewood. West Vigo number 9, Edgewood number 5 in the state this week. Sectional number 29, South Dearborn is the host. Batesville is the defending sectional champs. Lawrenceburg and Greensburg in game number 1, with the winner getting Madison. Then in the bottom half of the bracket, South Dearborn and Franklin County, Batesville and Rushville. Sectional number 30. Eight teams in this group. North Harrison is the host school. Brownstown and Scottsburg in game number 1. The defending state runners-up in Silver Creek in game number 2 take on Salem. Now in the bottom half of the bracket, Cordon Central and Charlestown, North Harrison and Providence. Providence playing up from Class 2A. And by the way, this is the final year for head coach Scott Horning, who has announced his retirement earlier this season. Sectional number 31, this is at Vincennes Lincoln. Five-team sectional grouping here. Washington, the defending sectional champs. They'll take on Gibson Southern in game number one, with the winner getting Princeton. Pike Central and Vincennes Lincoln in the top half of the bracket. And finally, sectional number 32, Bossy is the host school here. Bossy will take on Boonville in game number one, with the winner getting Heritage Hills. Top of the bracket, it is Mount Vernon, Evansville Memorial. Memorial, of course, a three-time former state champ, and they made it to the regional final a year ago. They are receiving votes in the coaches' poll this week. That'll do it for Class 3A. We've got one more group to show you. That would be sectionals 1 through 16 in the 4A bracket. And that comes your way next as we wind down this edition of the 2019 IHSAA Baseball Pairing Show right here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community and support the over 160,000 Indiana student-athletes that participate across 22 IHSAA sports. Sports officiating allows you to stay connected to the game, become a role model for our young student-athletes, earn extra money, and support the patrons and communities of our IHSAA member schools. To learn more about becoming a licensed IHSAA official, log on to ihsaa.org/officials today.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to ihsaatv.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
Welcome back for the final time here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. I'm your host, Greg Rakestraw. Thank you so much for joining us. We've got one more pairing show coming up. That would be girls tennis. That is about a week or so away, as their state tournament starts in just a matter of days. Of course, this state tournament starts on May 22nd. Sectionals, regionals, semi-states, and again, the state championships, same location, slightly different days. Monday and Tuesday after Father's Day weekend, Victory Field, downtown Indianapolis. Of course, for a full schedule, IHSAA.org has more. We've made you guys in 4A wait long enough. Let's get to the brackets now. We start in the northwest corner of the state. Sectional number one. This is hosted by Munster, and Munster takes on a team that's made their way to Victory Field multiple times before, Lake Central, in game number one. Lake Central is the defending sectional champ here. Lowell and Hammond-Morton in game number two. Highland and East Chicago Central in a semifinal. Loaded sectional two at Crown Point. Valpo and Merrillville in game number one. The Vikings receiving votes this week. Chesterton made the semi-state last year. Their opponent in game number one, the number one team in the state, Crown Point. On to the semifinals for Portage and Hobart. Sectional number three. This is at Plymouth. Seven teams in this group. LaPorte, eight state championships over the years for the Slicers. They take on South Bend Riley in game number one. Plymouth awaits in the semifinal. Bottom half of the bracket, Clay and Adams in game number two. Mishawaka won this sectional last year. They'll take on Michigan City in their opening game. The Cavemen, eighth in the state this week. Sectional number four. This is hosted by Elkhart Memorial. Again, seven teams in this group. Memorial and Goshen in game number one. Winner gets Penn. The Kingsmen are seventh. They were runners-up 2 years ago, state champs 4 years ago, and they have won five straight baseball sectionals. Bottom half of the bracket, Elkhart Central and Northridge, Warsaw and Concord. Sectional number five, this is hosted by DeKalb. Five teams in this group. Carroll, a previous state champ, takes on Snyder in game number one. Carroll made the regional final last year. Fort Wayne Northrop awaits in a semifinal game. DeKalb and East Noble in the top half of the bracket. Sectional number six, Huntington North is the host school, and they will take on Fort Wayne Wayne in game number one. Winner gets Fort Wayne Southside, who won this sectional last year. Top of the bracket, Northside and Homestead. Homestead tied for ninth in the state. Sectional number seven, this will be at Loeb Stadium in Lafayette, at Lafayette Jeff High School, the host. Kokomo and McCutcheon in game number one. Zionsville, who has won this sectional three straight years, will take on Harrison in game number two. Then it is Logansport and Lafayette Jeff in the awaiting in the semifinal. Sectional number eight. This is at the Dunk, as they call it, at Noblesville High School. Westfield and the defending state champs in Fishers in game number one. North Central and Hamilton Southeastern receiving votes in this week's coaches poll in game number two. Then it is Carmel and Noblesville on to the semifinals. Sectional number nine, Pendleton Heights is the host school here, and they get a bye to the semifinals. They will get the winner of Richmond and Muncie Central. Bottom half of the bracket, Connersville and Anderson. Mount Vernon of Fortville and Greenfield Central face off in another opening round game. Sectional number 10, this is hosted by NewPal. LN and Warren Central in game number one. Cathedral, last year's runners-up and a three-time state champ. They'll get Tech in game number two. Then LC and NewPal are in the semifinals. Sectional number 11, this is at Southport. Decatur Central and Perry Meridian in game number one. Ben Davis and Pike in game number two. On to the semis for Southport and Roncalli. Roncalli, the state champs 3 years ago, tied for ninth in the polls this week, and they have won a sectional in three consecutive seasons. Sectional number 12, Terre Haute North Vigo is the host here. Seven teams in this group. Avon and Plainfield in game number one, with the winner getting Northview. Terre Haute North and Mooresville in game number two. Terre Haute South and Brownsburg in game number three. Terre Haute South made it to the regional final a season ago. Sectional number 13, this is at Martinsville. Franklin and Franklin Central in game number one. Franklin Central won this sectional last year. Whiteland and Center Grove in game number two. The Trojans receiving votes in this week's coaches poll. Martinsville and Greenwood on to the semifinals. Sectional 14 East Central is the host here. Bloomington North, Bloomington South in game number one. Shelbyville and Columbus East, who is number four in the state, in game number two. I'm sorry, the Olympians are number three. The reason being, Columbus North is number four, and they play the host school East Central in the semifinals. Bloomington North is also receiving votes, so a lot of talent in sectional 14. Sectional number 15, this is hosted by Bedford North Lawrence. Six conference rivals in the Hoosier Hills Conference face each other here. Jennings County and Bedford North Lawrence in game number one. Floyd Central and Seymour in game number two, which sets up a rivalry game for sure in a semifinal. Jeffersonville, regional finalist last year in receiving votes. New Albany, number six in the state, and they'll play each other in the second semifinal. And finally, in sectional 16, Wrights is the host school here. Wrights and Central in game number one. North and Harrison in game number two, which sets up Castle, number two in the state, and they got to the semi-state last year, taking on five-time state champion Jasper, and Jasper number five in the state this week. What a great semifinal that'll be in Evansville, and what a matchup to end it on here as we have showed you 384 schools that will participate in the upcoming baseball state championship game. So again, sectional action begins on May 22nd, followed by regional, then semi-state play, and of course, the state championships this year, Monday and Tuesday at Victory Field, June 17th and June 18th. For a full rundown of the pairings, you can go right now to IHSAA.org. As always, it has more information. For Bobby Cox and Robert Falkins, as well as Heath Shanahan and Rick Van De Weyland behind the scenes, this is Greg Rakestraw. Thank you for watching, and best of luck to your team in the upcoming 2019 IHSAA baseball state tournament.